If you need to edit your PDFs, consider using I Love PDF, an online tool that also has a mobile and desktop version. It's free to use and can handle over 15 out of 25 typical tasks for editing PDFs. Most options are free to use, but for $5 a month, you can get access to them all. This is still a bargain compared to over $170 for Adobe Acrobat Pro. The I Love PDF free version has no limitations on the number of tasks you perform. However, the main thing it doesn't do is edit the existing text. To get started, go to ilovepdf.com and select Edit PDF. Then choose your file. To zoom in and out, avoid using your trackpad as it can be difficult to stabilize the view. Instead, use the zoom in or zoom out options at the top or select the fit width to fit to the screen size. When you select the hand icon, you are able to grab your PDF page and move it up or down to reposition it. On the left, you can see thumbnails of your PDF pages. You can click on one to jump directly to it, or use the arrows at the top to go to the previous or next page. If you want to add text, select the text option, click somewhere on your PDF and start typing. Unselect the text box to move it to a new place. The default font is not necessarily what is used in the PDF. You also can't edit the already existing text, which is often what you want to edit in the first place. Double-click to select the entire text inside and type something new. To format the text, make sure you select it all again, then go to the format menu at the top. You can make your text bold, italic, or underline it. Select each of the options again to undo. Select text color at the top to change it to one of the few available. You can also make the text bigger by selecting the predefined sizes, but you can't, unfortunately, type in your own size to match the text in the PDF. There are only 6 fonts to choose from, which is very limited, and the alignment option didn't exactly work for me as expected. Nothing happened. Choose a color to fill your text box from a selection of only 14 colors. After formatting, quickly create new text boxes with the same style by copying and pasting them. Then type in your new text. To annotate, click Add Shape at the top. If you select a line, you can change its color and stroke width. You can easily reposition and adjust the line after creating it. On the right-hand side of your PDF, you have a list of all your edits and annotations. At any time, you can reorder, edit, and remove them. To highlight text, go back to selecting a shape, and this time select a rectangle. Then reposition, resize, and change its color, and adjust the opacity to between 25 to 50% so you can see the text. It's not exactly highlighting, but more like placing a semi-transparent shape over text. To redact, you can copy and paste the highlight shape again and change it to black with 100% opacity. However, this is not suitable to redacting sensitive information as the text remains underneath. If you change the color to white, it can function as a whiteout. Now, if you try to add a link to text, it doesn't work. You can't edit already established links in the PDF either. If I try to type in google.com and see if a link is created, it doesn't work. You can add new images by selecting Add Image, then choosing the image. You can resize and reposition it and also rotate it. You can also change its opacity to use it as a background image if you like. Finally, I Love PDF supports layering, so you can add some text and layer it on top of your image. To reorganize the layers, you can reorder them on the right. If you are working with a PDF form, you can add an oval shape to simulate filling in a radio button. To create a proportional circle, hold the Option on Mac or Alt on PC. Then copy and paste the formatted oval for the other radio buttons. Under Symbols, you can also find check marks that you can resize and use, and red crosses for marking no's on the form. To fill out the form text boxes, use the Add Text option at the top. There are two ways to add a signature in I Love PDF. The first is to select the Draw option and manually sign the document. It might not look too pretty though, but it works as a last resort. The second option I will show you later on. You can't organize the page thumbnails here, but there's a special option for arranging pages that we will cover later. When you are done with all your edits and annotations, select Edit PDF. At this point, I can either download the file or choose from the additional editing options still available. Let's add a watermark to our document. I appreciate that the edited document reopens seamlessly for further edits. I can either add a watermark text or image. I will add a draft text in the middle of the page. The red dot indicates the watermark placement. I can change the size of the watermark, although it is hard to gauge how big it is as the red dot stays the same size. You just have to guesstimate and test it. I will make it transparent at 45 degree angle and keep it over the PDF content. When I select the Add Watermark button, I get an option to download it now. I like how the downloaded copy retains my original file name with the new edits appended to the end. When I preview it, I can see all the edits as well as the draft watermark, which is a bit small, but again, I couldn't tell how big it would be beforehand. I can continue editing my PDF with the other options. I will select Adding Page Numbers. I can choose between single or facing pages, adjust the placement of the page numbers, and decide whether I want to display just the page number or the page number out of the total count. Once I am done, I can download the file and preview it. And that looks great. I will also use the Organize Pages option to add new pages and rearrange my file. To add a new page, select the Add a Blank Page icon next to each. To reorganize, grab the page that you want to move and move it over where you wanted it to be placed. At any point, you can also delete a page from your file. My downloaded file has a new organized text next to its file name. Super helpful. As promised, I will demonstrate the second method for adding a signature, which is a more professional approach. Let's select Sign PDF and the Only Me Will Sign option. Type in your full name and select the type of font you want to use for your signature and color. On the left, you also get to draw your signature, which is what we used before. Or upload an image of your signature if you have it saved somewhere. I will go back to my text option. With this option, I can also insert my initials into the document. Once I'm satisfied, I will select Apply. Now I have a message telling me I can drag and drop the newly created signature to where I wanted it to be. I can resize it and remove it by clicking the X in the top right corner. The second option that appears is Place Field. When you select it, you can specify where you wanted it to be placed, on all or specific pages. This is helpful when you want to initial each page of your file. I'm going to select the signed version of my downloaded file to preview it. I can see that everything is exactly as I specified. Apart from the inability to edit existing text, I Love PDF is a good PDF editor. Thanks so much for watching!